Dengue. Dengue is a mosquito-borne and pandemic-prone viral infection prevalent in many parts of the world. Virus. Dengue is caused by a virus belonging to the Flaviviridae family, of which there are four distinct serotypes: Dengue Virus 1, Dengue Virus 2, Dengue Virus 3, and Dengue Virus 4. It is important to have knowledge of these serotypes because recovery from a dengue infection will provide lifelong immunity against that serotype only. Subsequent infections from other serotypes will increase the risk of developing severe disease. Transmission. The virus is spread via the bite of a mosquito, mostly by Aedes aegypti, and to a lesser extent, by Aedes albopictus mosquito. Important to note here is the fact that these very same mosquitoes are involved in the spread of other viral diseases, including chikungunya and Zika. The mosquito can become infectious when it bites an infected individual. It then carries the dengue virus and injects them into another individual during its next meal. Dengue doesn't spread directly from one patient to the next. These mosquitoes can typically be found laying eggs near standing water in containers that hold water like buckets, bowls, animal dishes, and others. The incubation period of dengue is 4 to 10 days once the mosquito has bitten the individual. Symptoms. Dengue can cause a wide range of symptoms in a patient, from a subclinical disease in which the patient might be unaware of the infection, to a severe infection, in which the patient exhibits severe flu-like symptoms. The symptoms of dengue include high-grade fever around 40 degrees C or 104 Fahrenheit, along with nausea, vomiting, which is generally non-bilious, rash, aches and pains typically involving the area behind the eye, which is termed as retroorbital pain, severe headache, generalized muscle pain, and joint pains. In case of a mild encounter, the patient will recover in about a week. In some cases, however, symptoms can worsen and become life-threatening. Blood vessels become affected adversely and eventually get leaky. The clot-forming platelets in the blood decrease in number, which leads to increased susceptibility of the patient to bleed. This condition is known as severe dengue or dengue hemorrhagic fever. This is characterized by severe abdominal pain, persistent vomiting at least 3 times in 24 hours, bleeding from the patient's nose, called epistaxis, bleeding from gums, bleeding under the skin, which appears like purplish bruises, feeling tired and restless, blood in the urine, also known as hematuria, blood observed in the stool and vomit, and eventually, the patient can slip into shock. They may have cold, clammy skin, tachycardia, and hypertension. Risk factors. Factors like living in or traveling to tropical areas can increase one's risk of exposure to this virus. The more high-risk areas include Southeast Asia, the Western Pacific Islands, Latin America, and the Caribbean. Prior infection with a dengue fever virus can also result in severe episodes of disease if infected again, with a high probability of developing dengue hemorrhagic fever. Investigation. Detailed investigations need to be carried out if the patient exhibits symptoms of dengue and has the aforementioned risk factors. Dengue virus infections can be confirmed by employing virological tests that detect the virus of their element, or serological tests that detect the substances produced in our body during the infection. The examples of virological methods include 1. Virus isolation. The patient's blood is taken to be grown inside the mosquitoes or their cells. After 2 weeks, the presence of the virus in the animal's blood indicates the virus infection. 2. Reverse transcriptase polymerase chain reaction, or RT-PCR methods. The purpose is to multiply the viral RNA by using enzymes several cycle times until it can be detected. In general, these tests are sensitive, but they require specialized equipment and technical training for implementing the test, which might not always be available in all medical facilities. The examples of serological methods are 1. NS1 detection. NS1 is a protein produced by the cells that are infected by the dengue viruses. 2. Enzyme-linked immunosorbent assays, or ELISA. It detects the antibodies that are produced by our body to fight the viruses. Treatment. The specific treatment for dengue fever is not available yet, but there are several general treatments that can be introduced to patients, such as antipyretics to reduce fever and painkillers to treat muscle or joint pain. However, NSAID, or non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, like ibuprofen and aspirin, should be avoided. They thin the blood and can exacerbate the prognosis of disease with hemorrhage risk. For severe dengue, intensive medical care by physicians and nurses can decrease the progression of the disease and the mortality rates from more than 20% to less than 1%. The management of the patient's body fluid volume is critical to severe dengue care. Vaccination against dengue. The first dengue vaccine, Dengvaxia, or CYD-TDV, was licensed in December 2015 and has now been approved by regulatory authorities in around 18 to 20 countries. The use of the vaccine is targeted at populations living in endemic areas, ranging from 9 to 45 years of age, who have had at least one documented dengue virus infection previously. The vaccine is given in 3 doses over the course of 12 months, but its efficacy is a matter of debate. The vaccine is only approved for older children, because 2 years after being vaccinated, the younger ones appear to be at increased risk of severe dengue fever and hospitalization. The World Health Organization, WHO, stresses that the vaccine is not the most effective tool. Prevention. A more important matter than treatment and vaccines is controlling the mosquito population and human exposure. So, to avoid getting dengue, our best shot is to avoid getting bitten by the mosquitoes carrying dengue. It is as simple as that. If you are a resident of or traveler to any tropical area where dengue fever is previously reported, prevention can reduce your risk of acquiring it, which includes: stay in air-conditioned or well-screened housing, because the mosquitoes that carry dengue viruses are relatively more active from dawn to dusk. Wear protective clothing, like a long-sleeved shirt, long pants, socks and shoes. Use mosquito repellents, like permethrin, to be applied to your clothing, shoes, camping gear, and bed netting. And most importantly, reduce mosquito habitat. You can lower mosquito populations by eliminating habitats where they lay their eggs at least once a week, and emptying and cleaning containers that hold standing water, such as planting containers, animal dishes, and flower vases. Keep standing water containers covered between cleanings. Foreign aid. Recently, scientists from Australia and Indonesia are working together to fight the disease. They turn to another creature, a bacteria called Wolbachia. They inject the bacteria into the mosquito's eggs, breed them in the laboratory, and release them into the wild. Then, the spy mosquitoes will eventually mate with the natural, disease-ridden of their kind. Naturally, their babies will also carry the bacteria from the spy father. It has the ability to disrupt the reproductive process of the mosquito, while also reducing the lifespan of their offspring, preventing the next generation of mosquitoes from spreading dengue altogether. The early results are extraordinary. Adults in areas with previously released mosquitoes have 4 times less chance to have dengue disease, giving us the best hope so far to eradicate the dengue endemic.